Welcome to Newsmax TV. I'm Kathleen Walter. With us now from Washington is Congressman Bob Goodlatte, Republican from Virginia and chairman of the House Judiciary Committee. And Congressman Goodlatte, thanks for joining us today.
Glad to be with you and your listeners.
Attorney General Eric Holder recently appeared before the House Judiciary Committee, where he said that targeting journalists was not something I've ever been involved in, heard of, or would think would be wise policy. However, since that time, NBC News reported that Eric Holder personally sanctioned a search warrant labeling Fox News correspondent James Rosen a co-conspirator in leaking secrets about national security. Does it appear to you that Eric Holder might be guilty of perjury and is now caught in a lie?
Well, we are sending a letter, myself and the chairman of the Crime, Terrorism, Homeland Security and Investigation Subcommittee this morning, asking him to explain how his answers to the committee conflict with the actions that he appears to have taken with regard to Mr. Rosen, and will withhold judgment on what the Attorney General's actions constitute until we give an opportunity for him to explain himself. But it is quite concerning that he made statements that would seem to indicate that he has taken a different approach than the approach he's actually taken with regard to investigating reporters when there have been leaks from government agencies.
So can you confirm then that the Judiciary Committee is investigating this, and do you plan to bring Eric Holder back before the committee?
Well, the committee has been investigating the matter with regard to the Associated Press investigation and the subpoenas issued there, which appear to have been overbroad, and both in terms of the number of reporters whose phone call records were sought, as well as the length of time, 60 days, that was involved in that, and some questions about the Attorney General's involvement in that, where he said that he recused himself and turned that responsibility over to the Deputy Attorney General, James Cole. So we have already sent a letter to Mr. Cole asking him a series of questions regarding how that matter took place. Now we are pursuing it further with regard to the Fox News matter with regard to Mr. Rosen. And we have sent a letter this morning to the Attorney General asking him to explain how the information that we have regarding the search warrant with Mr. Rosen conflicts with his testimony, his sworn testimony before the committee. So we are very concerned about the Justice Department targeting reporters and using what could be overbroad investigative tools to harass the news media, and we want to make sure that they are following the rules. But now we're also concerned about the fact that Mr. Holder has, again, contradicted himself, and we want to know why that is. We'll wait for an answer to that before we decide what our next step is in terms of committee hearings.
But looking at all the evidence in the testimony right now, does it appear to you that Justice acted lawfully in subpoenaing the telephone records of the Associated Press as part of a criminal investigation into a national security leak?
We need to make sure that we get all of the information that we're requesting from Mr. Holder and Mr. Cole before we jump to conclusions. But we are very concerned about this, and that's why these two letters, one sent last week and one being sent today, will delve further into the actions of the Justice Department and Mr. Holder and Mr. Cole.
Senator Lindsey Graham has called for an independent special counsel to investigate the IRS and Justice Department scandals. Is an independent special counsel or a select committee needed here?
Well, the fact of the matter is, again, if we find sufficient information to justify getting this off onto a separate track and delaying the investigation while a special select committee or a special counsel is appointed, we will do that. But at this point in time, we think it's important that the committees involved, and it's not just the Judiciary Committee, but with regard to the IRS, it's also the Ways and Means Committee and the Oversight and Government Reform Committee, that we continue to pursue this investigation aggressively and look into the matter. And if we were to sidetrack to get to a select committee, that will slow down this process. And we think that at this point in time, the committee should continue to investigate, and there will be a decision made later on about whether or not we need to take a different course with regard to these investigations.
Many Republicans have called for Eric Holder's resignation. Should he resign?
Well, last year in the last Congress, I co-sponsored a resolution calling for him to step down, and he has still not complied with the subpoena that was given to him with regard to the investigation of Fast and Furious. And the result of that is that his noncompliance, his having been held in contempt of the House of Representatives, all indicates to me his unwillingness to take responsibility for the actions in the Justice Department, his inability to provide leadership, and therefore it is very concerning to me. And I see nothing that would change my opinion from 2 years ago that he should step down.
Let's switch gears real quickly and chat for a second about immigration reform legislation. You have offered a piecemeal approach to immigration reform in the House. Can you tell us about this? And in your view, what is the best way to deal with the more than 11 million immigrants here illegally?
Well, we are taking a step-by-step approach in the House of Representatives. We appreciate the effort that is ongoing in the Senate. We have a broken immigration system, and it needs to be fixed, both fixed in the sense of enforcing our immigration laws and in the sense of finding the appropriate legal status for those who are not lawfully present in the United States today. We also want to make sure that we're doing everything possible to improve our legal immigration system, because we think it could work much better from the standpoint of the national interests of the United States and American citizens in creating jobs and growing our economy. So we are hard at work. We have introduced now three bills in the House Judiciary Committee dealing with various aspects of immigration reform. The Homeland Security Committee has introduced and passed out of the committee a fourth bill dealing with border security. Next week, we will introduce in the Judiciary Committee a fifth bill dealing with interior security, because the problem is not just at the border. 35% to 40% of the people who are not lawfully present in the United States entered the country legally on visitors' visas, business visas, student visas, visa waivers, et cetera, and simply overstayed their visa. So fixing the issues on the border does not by any means completely solve the problem. And in fact, some would argue that the biggest problem that we have right now is the lack of enforcement in the interior of the country. So look for that bill next week. We are also continuing to work on the issue of what the legal status of people not lawfully present in the United States should be. I do not support a special pathway to citizenship that would give people who entered the country unlawfully a advantage over people who have been attempting, in some cases for many, many years, to lawfully immigrate to the United States. And all of these things taken in a step-by-step approach where we figure out what the way forward is in terms of enforcing our immigration laws, adding new enforcement measures, making sure that no president of the United States, not just President Obama, but no president can flip a switch and determine not to enforce the immigration laws as they pertain to millions of people who are not here lawfully, and to make sure that we do not undertake something that will cost the taxpayers of this country huge sums of money, are all matters that we are working our way through one step at a time.
You have gone on record saying the Senate immigration bill falls far short. What are your concerns? Is the pathway to citizenship the biggest concern that you have?
The biggest concern I have is that they provide a legal status long before they ever give anybody a pathway to citizenship. They almost immediately give a legal status to people before they have in place the measures that would assure that we don't have a repeat of what happened in 1986, when 3 million people were given an easy pathway to citizenship and the enforcement measures never were seriously implemented, the employer sanctions and other things. Now we have new measures like E-Verify, which is a voluntary system. We want it made mandatory for every employer in the United States, and that would be implemented under the Senate rule after they've given legal status to millions of people. We're also very concerned about the costs that are entailed in the Senate bill, and we're also very concerned about the lack of interior enforcement measures, a role for state and local government to help the very limited number of immigration, Homeland Security employees who are responsible for enforcing our immigration laws, and making sure that there are not a lot of waivers in the legislation that would give this president or any president the ability to simply not enforce the law. That's what happened for the last 25 or more years, and we've got to make sure that if we are going to change the legal status of millions of people, that we don't have another tidal wave of people coming into the country after them.
All right, last question for you. Let's say for a second that the Senate legislation ends up in the House as is. Do you believe Speaker Boehner would bring it to a vote, and could this legislation even pass the House?
Well, we are not to that point yet. There are a lot of different alternatives. We have a group in the House, a bipartisan group that is working on legislation. They have not completed that legislation yet, but once they have a bill, we will take a look at that and work with that in conjunction with the legislation that several members, including myself, have introduced through the House Judiciary Committee. And again, a step-by-step approach to this is the best way to solve all three areas of the immigration issue: the legal immigration reforms, the enforcement issues, and finding a legal status for those who are not lawfully present in the United States. But we're not there yet, so stay tuned.
All right, Congressman Bob Goodlatte, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching Newsmax TV.